Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a modern art lithograph portrait. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button and please remember to click like. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. I provided four different brushes that we'll be using in this video. The link to the folder that I placed the brushes into is located in my video's description or project files. Let's crop our photo to the size and position we'd like to see our final image to be. Open the Crop tool and open the Crop preset list. Click the Width, Height, and Resolution option and click the Clear button, which clears all the fields. To ensure that your final result will look similar to mine, type in 150 pixels per inch for its resolution. Otherwise, you'll have to adjust some of the filter and brush sizes to compensate for the larger or smaller resolution of your document. I'll type in 1920 pixels for its width. However, feel free to make yours any amount. Keep its height empty, which will give us the freedom to make its aspect ratio any shape we want. The height will automatically be filled in once we crop our image. Go to any of the corners and drag them in to size your subject. To reposition it inside the bounding box, just drag your photo. Once you're happy with its size and position, press Enter or Return twice, or click the check mark at the top. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Before we add the first filter, we need to check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Black should be our foreground color. If the colors are inverted, press X. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Charcoal. I'll make the charcoal thickness 4, the detail 5, and the light-dark balance 80. However, feel free to adjust these amounts based on the characteristics of your photo. Next, we'll thicken up any lines along its outer edge. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. After you install the four custom brushes I provided, open the Pastel on Charcoal paper. Make the size 25 pixels and press Enter or Return. Change the Blend Mode to Dissolve and make its opacity 80%. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Brush Settings panel, or you could go to Window and Brush Settings. Click Shape Dynamics and drag the Angle Jitter all the way to the right. Angle Jitter randomly rotates our brush as we paint. At 100%, our brush can rotate up to 360 degrees. If you're using version CC 2018 or later, make the smoothing 100%. Smoothing basically makes our strokes smooth as we brush. I did a quick tutorial about this feature, so if you'd like to watch it, I included its link as well. Brush over thin lines along their outer edge to thicken them. I'll brush over the hair as well, but before I do, I'll reduce the smoothing to 0%. I'll increase the size of my brush by pressing the right bracket key on my keyboard and brush over the hair. To brush white over some areas, invert your foreground and background colors and brush over those areas. Next, we'll loosely brush in some midtones and shadows. Make a new layer. Open the Brush Picker and close the Open folder. Open the Pastel on Charcoal Paper 2 folder and click the brush. I'll type in 600 pixels, but feel free to adjust the amount for your subject. Make the Blend Mode Dissolve, the Opacity 25%, and the Flow 25%. The difference between opacity and flow is this. Opacity controls the transparency of the paint, and flow controls the speed at which the paint is laid down, much like painting with a spray paint can. Open the Brush Settings panel and increase the Angle Jitter to 100%. Invert the colors so black is your foreground color. Brush over your subject to add midtones and shadows, and feel free to adjust the brush's size. To brush white over your subject, just invert the colors and make the opacity approximately 50%. Brush over areas you'd like to lighten. We'll place all the layers into a folder by shift-clicking the bottom layer to make all the layers active and pressing Ctrl or Command G. Name it Subject. Change the folder's blend mode to Multiply. This blend mode makes all the white areas of our subject transparent, thereby allowing the colors that we'll be placing under our subject to be visible. Make a new layer below the folder by Ctrl or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white, and since our foreground color is white, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Place it into a new folder, make the layer active, and make a new layer above it. Open the brush picker and click the brush inside the acrylic brush folder. I'll make its size 1200 pixels, but keep in mind your brush sizes and how they're applied to your portrait are completely subjective. I'll change the blend mode to normal and its opacity and flow to 100%. Open the brush settings panel and click Shape Dynamics. Drag the angle jitter to 100%. Click the foreground color to open the color picker and pick any color you want. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field. Once you pick your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Brush over your subject. For your next layer of color, make a new layer. Click the foreground color and pick another color. Brush over your image and feel free to adjust the brush's size if you like to. Continue to make new layers for each time you use a brush, pick colors, and apply different brush strokes. Play with their blend modes and opacity as well to see how they interact with other colors until you have the look you want. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.